The face and the sound of this man will be instantly recognizable to connoisseurs of great piano playing the world over. The appearance aloof, rather imperious, and the platform manner detached, withdrawn, even a little disdainful. The playing, that of the ultimate virtuoso, displaying a command of the keyboard which no other pianist alive can surpass, and which few can equal. Together they add up to one of the most exclusive and elusive musicians of our time, Arturo Benedetti Michelangeli, who in one of his rare television appearances will be playing the Ravel Concerto in G Major accompanied by the London Symphony Orchestra under the Romanian conductor Sergiu Celibidache. The atmosphere of rarity and mystery which has grown round Michelangeli is by no means dispelled by the biography of the man written in the programme of one of his own recitals. Legend has it that he is descended from St. Francis of Assisi. Violinist, organist, doctor, Franciscan monk, he spent a year in a monastery, pilot, racing car driver, first-class skier and piano technician, he can take a concert grand to pieces and reconstruct it. Arturo Benedetti Michelangeli is unique. Well, to add a few further facts to the legend, he was born in Brescia in Italy in January 1920, and at the age of three began to study the violin, an instrument he later discarded after an attack of pneumonia, which developed into TB. He started playing the piano when he was about 10, appears to have been largely self-taught, and at the age of 19 won the prestigious Geneva International Piano Competition. As a concession to his aristocratic parents, he studied medicine for 5 years at university, but nonetheless it was as a concert pianist that he finally decided to make his living. Since then his career has spanned over 40 years, during which he has earned a notorious reputation as a fanatical perfectionist. He is one of less than a handful of musicians who insist on travelling their own piano. Sometimes he even tours with two, and if he detects the slightest flaw in the instrument, he simply refuses to play at all. His schedules have been littered with scores of cancelled concerts and broken engagements, some called off at such short notice that his audience was already arriving at the hall. When he does appear, his supreme ability is beyond dispute. Wrong notes are virtually unknown. But critics and fellow musicians have increasingly begun to claim, with some justification, that the fabulous refinement of his playing is largely due to the constant repetition of a remarkably limited number of works. One American pianist, on hearing a music lover rave about a Michelangeli recital, dryly inquired, "What was he playing, Programme A or Programme B?" And although the remark is not entirely without malice, it is true that few players have built such a colossal reputation on so small a repertoire and on so lamentably few appearances. Other musicians take a different view, among them the conductor of tonight's performance, Sergiu Celibidache, himself a single-minded perfectionist whose dislike of the recording studio and insistence on long periods of rehearsal have earned him a reputation of being almost as eccentric as Michelangeli himself.
Nobody can judge that. Nobody can have the sensitiveness he's got. Nobody can judge why his instrument is not fit to play on that night, half an hour before the concert. Because of humidity, of temperature, the instrument can be completely ruined. But for his fingers, for his ear, for his consciousness, not for us, no one can judge why he is not able to play on a certain instruments. He goes all over the places with two instruments of his own, and sometimes none of them is playable. But who is going to say why not? I assisted myself. We had once four technicians and two instruments, and everybody running all day long to put that right. Nobody could.
So when you say you think he's the greatest artist in music, or one of the greatest artists anyhow, you suggest that his sensitivity is way beyond that of
art is not only sensitivity. It's a part of it. You must be sensitive to the various values which develop themselves in music. This is one aspect of it. But he's the only one where the climax of the piece is in steady relation, potential relation, steady with the beginning and the end.